Hi friends, my name is Chaitanya Patki and welcome back to my YouTube channel. As I had promised earlier, in this video, I am going to analyze the most successful team in IPL history, that is the Mumbai Indians. As you know, the Mumbai Indians are the defending two-time champions. They have won the IPL titles 5 times. Their first title came in 2013, followed by 15, 17, 19 and 2020. Will it make it 3 years out of three? That is the biggest question on the mind of every cricket fan following the IPL around the world. First, we are going to see the batsman of the Mumbai Indians. First is Rohit Sharma, their Mercurial and talismanic skipper. Then Saurabh Tiwari. Surya Kumar Yadav will come in most likely at number 3. Ishan Kishan is the wicketkeeper batsman. Quinton de Kock will open with Rohit Sharma. Chris Lynn, who didn't got a game last season. So you can determine how tough the competition in the Mumbai Indians is, because Chris Lynn is a very explosive player. In any other league besides the IPL in the world, he could get easily the opening slot, but not in the IPL. Anmolpreet Singh, a good young talent. And Aditya Tare, the Vijay Hazare Trophy winning skipper of Mumbai, he is a very good player. For many years, he has been their backup batsman. All-rounders, now Mumbai Indians have a settled core as their all-rounders. The Pandya brothers, Hardik Pandya and Krunal Pandya, the vice captain of the team, Kyron Pollard, James Nisham, which they bought for rupees 50 lakh, that was a steal, I think. Anukul Roy, who was mainly used as a substitute fielder, very electric fielder. He's a good left-arm bowler and a decent middle-order batsman. Arjun Tendulkar, there has been much debate about the selection of Arjun Tendulkar and Marco Jensen. Marco Jensen, as I had mentioned in the previous Marathi video, is a tall, lanky, fast bowler from South Africa, who impressed everyone in the nets when India toured South Africa in 2017-18. He also impressed the current A coach of the Indian team, Mr. Rahul Dravid, and Virat Kohli also had some nice words to say about this youngster. So, fingers are crossed, I hope he performs well if he gets the chance. Fast bowlers are the same. The core is retained. Jasprit Bumrah, I think the best white ball bowler in the world going around. Then Trent Bolt, Nathan Coulter-Nile, Mohsin Khan, which is a youngster. He performed well in the Vijay Hazare Trophy this season. Adam Mills, the lanky tearaway New Zealand fast bowler, who has been around for quite some time, but it is very inconsistent. But in the last domestic T20 competition in New Zealand, he has regained his form and he has also regained his place in the New Zealand T20 team. That's why he has been selected. Spinners, there are three spinners. Rahul Chahar has been retained. Piyush Chawla has been brought from the Chennai Super Kings, and Jayant Yadav is also retained. Now we are going to analyze the players released and players bought. Traditionally, Mumbai Indians has been the most smart franchise. They go about their business in a very tactical manner, and not in the history they have spent more than 10 crore on a single player. Ironically, that player was Rohit Sharma, which they bought in the 2011 auction, which has turned out to be quite a great investment for them. So first, I will tell you which are the player released. Prince Balwant Rai, which is a leg spinner, he didn't get any game time last season. Then Digvijay Deshmukh, Lasith Malinga, probably the greatest, certainly the greatest T20 bowler of all time. Nathan Coulter-Nile, they released and they bought him back. James Pattinson, this was actually a very, I think, baffling selection to be player released, because James Pattinson took 13 wickets last year. So I think the team management erred in this, but that's their plan, I guess. Sherman Rutherford, he bats in the lower order, and Mitchell McLanaghan, who didn't game a game in the last season. The players bought this season are Adam Milne for rupees 3.2 crore, Piyush Chawla for 2.4 crore, James Nisham for 50 lakh, Nathan Coulter-Nile for rupees 5 crore. Now Nathan Coulter-Nile is a very interesting selection, because they released him. They bought him for 8 crore last year and they bought him back for 5 crore. So 3 crore rupees saved by the team management. That is a very good tactical nous and great tactical thinking on the part of the Mumbai Indians team management. As you know, Mahila Jayawardene is their head coach. Zahir Khan has also been in the setup for quite some time. So such tactical understanding of the game is expected of the two. Then they brought Yudhvir Singh, which is a fast bowler, for rupees 20 lakh. Marco Jensen, which I mentioned earlier in the video, for rupees 20 lakh. And Arjun Tendulkar, the son of the legendary batsman Sachin Tendulkar, for rupees 20 lakh. Total players are 25. 18 players are Indian players and 7 players are overseas players. So I think Mumbai Indians they'll start the favorites for the title because they have all their bases covered, their base is strong, and they have good understanding of the conditions. Even though any of the team is not playing this year at their home ground, Mumbai Indians seem to be the well-equipped and the most equipped side, and they certainly look to defend their title. One special mention before ending the video, I would like to mention about Arjun Tendulkar. See, Arjun Tendulkar should be left alone. He is a very good left-arm fast-medium bowler. He is a decent lower down the order batsman. The problem is that he is the son of Sachin Tendulkar. So actually people will have very high hopes of him because of his surname. What his father has done for Indian cricket and world cricket is unparalleled, and nobody is going to question his legacy. But I think we should not judge Arjun from his father's name. Because many a times we see promising kids fall away due to the spotlight being on them. As I said, Arjun Tendulkar was brought for rupees 20 lakh, so there was a lot of debate about Arjun. In the other cases, Marco Jensen has been also brought for rupees 20 lakh. Yudhvir Singh has also been brought for rupees 20 lakh, but no one is talking about them. Only they are talking about Arjun Tendulkar because of Sachin Tendulkar. So I guess he's a good batsman. First I saw Arjun in 2015-16 when he was bowling to the great England captain Alistair Cook, who retired 3 years ago. So he was also impressed, and Arjun Tendulkar also served as a net bowler for the Indian team in various tournaments, including the World Cup. So there is no doubt about his talent. We just need to give him more time, and please don't just hate him and just say he is a product of nepotism, because that is the debate going around in Bollywood and in India, all the spheres, this nepotism debate is going around. So I wish him the best of luck. Please don't pressurize him. He is a great talent. He is a future prospect, and he will play for India someday, certainly. Plus, please don't give him undue attention, because we can spoil a player, and that would be very harsh. That's my analysis of Mumbai Indians. I hope you liked it. Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel, and tell in the comment section below. And please, I am telling it once again, I am new to YouTube. Please tell in the comment section if I need any improvements. I will pay heed to each and every comment and improvement. So please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.